Hey, 1 2 1 2 breaker one niner. 1 2 1 2 breaker of one motherfucking niner. We're gonna do some practice today. Practice. So, get the fuck out of my face, that bullshit, man. Tell him again. Hey. Hey, nah. Up your mouth. Oh, I said, shut her mouth. Up your goddamn mouth. I'm sorry. Sucked up. Up and down, hooping and shit. What's up, man? What's up, Cole? You about to stop that nigga? Okay, I got you. Bugger. I have a gun. They call it Monkey Man. Yeah. Ball. Ball. I'm giving ball. Ball. Quickly. Quickly, give me ball. Give me ball. There you go, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Give me the ball, nigga. Come on, ball. Ball. Ball, boy. Ball, boy. Yeah, damn ball. Come on, now. Ball. I'm talking about ball. I need ball. Ball boy. That's that. Give him the bound. Protect him. Rim bottom. Duke your balls out. That'll be a dunk contest, nigga. Name's Mike. Microphone. Mike, nigga. It's 1-on-1. Don't need a little nigga. That 1-on-1 game. Lean by. Back on the old contention. Last time you saw me get down. But there. My ass, Sammy. Did that, Sammy? Oh, yeah. Yeah, nigga. No more. up on the line. All right.
That's what we're gonna do.
Lapping his ass. Team practice ended. That's next. On that one, then. On to that.
Thank you. City of Charlotte, North Carolina is the second start broadcast tonight. And isn't the view magnificent? The Bulls are looking to defeat their Eastern Conference rival going into this one. 2K Sports is proud to present NBA basketball. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge is our sideline reporter. And back in Charlotte, following the road trip, it's the Hornets back on their home floor. It has not been a dramatic change this season to the performance last year in terms of the record, guys. Every game, though, a chance to get more than one. So you want to... playing in these early stages of the season, what are some of the things you're looking to accomplish here?
Well, you're of the culture, which means that guys are getting to early, practicing that, telling them to shoot around, they're paying attention to during the game. But it's more than X's and O's, it's about that culture, that winning, where you're doing all the things. So you want to make sure that every is all dialed in, that they're sacrificing, that the team is the most important thing to them in the season. And you can tell that every day by how they practice their routines and then their effort on the court.
So sometimes early on, it's more than just the wins and losses. Deceiving?
Yeah, definitely. Those are deceiving. Throw those out the window. You're building win habits. If you're building that castle on sand, so to speak, you're going to get knocked down when you get to play against a really good player. You're just kind of building up extra confidence, thinking of yourself more than you ought to. I had a great coach always tell me that if you worry about the process, the wins and losses will come. If you worry about the wins and losses, you totally lose control of the process, and all heck can break loose.
I like that. Well said. Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. Markkanen and Lopez are together down low. Wells is out there with Payne, and it's Warren in at the three spot. Now here's Payne. He had 10 points in the win against Orlando. They set the pick. Markkanen dishes to Warren. Wells in the corner. No good for Nassau.
Even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
And Walker kicks to Batum. Six on the shot clock. Shoots the three. Shot clock reset for Charlotte. Now Walker, he's coming off a 28-point game against Houston.
Yeah, and his offense, too. He was more than a half steal.
Now here's Batum. Pass to Fareed. Markkanen pulls it in.
Does well to burrow his way into the post, but loses his touch on the finish.
Wells kicks to Payne. There's Wells. Lopez a screen. From the wing, Wells good. Wells has got 5 points so far.
And Wells really had that mid-range area of the floor, capable of hitting these shots in bunches.
Now, here's Walker. Screen by Fareed. And Walker kicks to Stevenson. Nice feed that time from Walker. And it's all not enough.
He could go for a big game if they don't D him up on the perimeter.
And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who spoke with Steve Clifford. David.
I asked him to sum up their season to this point. He said, look, there's room for improvement, but there are a lot of positives we can draw from. He just wants to see more consistency every night. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, David. Over in the... Kaminsky in the corner. And no good. And a chance to take the lead. Goes gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. In the bucket on the assist from Payne. Warren's got his first points of the night.
Awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
Well, that opening right there, that's just because the defense failed to rotate.
Now, here's Stevenson. 18-point outing in the last game against the Rockets in Houston.
Well, Kevin, that with the defense trying to take shot opportunities away from him, he finds a way to get himself to the line.
Clearly a foul.
Charlotte shooting their first foul shots of the night here.
And just to mention, a season ago, they were very comfortable at the line, hitting about 78% free
right,
throws.
Take a break. Two shots.
No good on that.
one of the most disciplined teams, Greg, in the NBA.
Yeah, you look at how this team takes care of the ball, and from the first guy to the last, it says something about how much pride they take in that. Minimizing turnovers goes a long way in terms of winning games. It's part of the basketball that's for quite some time.
And he sinks the second. And here in the first quarter, with a little over played, Payne kicks the Markkanen. He's looking for Lopez and finds him. They set the pick. Lopez, a screen on Batum, off the pick and took it right in.
Oh, simple screen, but there was a defensive mix-up that left the man wide open.
And Stevenson kicks to Kaminsky. Side to Walker. 12 feet out. Fareed, great positioning on the putback.
That is really good. On the offensive glass.
Payne with it. He hasn't given up any points in this one. Now the feed to Wells. He dishes it to Lopez. Just four to shoot. Over Kaminsky. Doesn't go for it. And it's the Hornets taking it the other way. Coming into this, having notched a win against the Rockets in their last game.
Away from home, you got to execute. And they did that flawlessly.
Yeah, and they also controlled the pace of the game for most of the night. Outstanding effort in a hostile environment.
Wells with the steal. And here's the Thessals leading the way. And there's the lay-in. Wells by three. Here is Stevenson. And that ball. Time from Stevenson.
Well, the shooter walks.
Okay, all right, all right. Body on body. Hey, about to come. About to get warm. It's 30. It's the end of May.
By Lance Stevenson. Just to warn. Payne kicks the ball. Bulls moving the ball around. Marks the pick for Payne. And it comes off the front of the for Charlotte. Five of 10 shots to drive.
Like I'm talking.
Here's Walker. Move to get the 2 points. Second bucket tonight. I don't think many players. Many other by Steve Clifford.
Right now.
VP. He'll dismantle the media and players. There's one reason players.
Okay, here we go.
First anchor is one of the rare honors for it to have their jersey retired. What does an honor like that feel like? What does that mean?
Man, it meant so much to have my jersey retired. I was there with my family, my wife, sisters, parents, and everyone. It was just a really, you know, when you're playing it, you can really, you never really can really enjoy it. Days you're always thinking it hit better. So it was just a really cool moment to sit about all the positive things we did in the city for the definitely for the game and you know Sacramento for that and
wonderful years indeed. Here's Valentine Hornets with the rebound.
That one gives them a plus five rebound.
And he finishes nicely on the left. And the Hornets
feel Chris works for these shots.
Miko hit it.
Wide open yeah. From 3 point range. Self going with the triple, his first pass.
Amazing work. Really sick.
Valentine, great one. 32 seconds left in the first. Policio, and he got the whistle.
Yeah, big baby.
Second chance for Eddie at Charlotte.
Making hey, this guy.
Hornets have gone into the field in the first. Hit, but and land kicks. Zeller, pick for Walker. It's in the game.
Down by a couple.
5-4. Play just after this short break. And before the game, Walker, we talked about has been
definitely up.
All right, getting adjusted. And when you can see, and through that, for me, their work on this has been the
well, that means extra possession.
Zeller is out there with the nurse guys. Kid Gilchrist, second. Let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. The great one in the Magic. Quite a performance. He scored 32 points and it's all night long. A cold spell. Try to keep him on.
David, appreciate the report. He was on.
And you know,
it's interesting
to see how.
Miko. Oh man, shit.
Get there first and be
left sidewalk. Ellen time. Here's Zellerbound.
That's how you protect the Walter in the release.
A screen. One passes to Philly. And the foul call one.
Oh my.
Positioning boxed out. Counted. Ain't too much hustle. Just a little bit.
Hit by Zeller. Hit now dark. Back is to Zeller. 14 feet away. It is that efficiency like about his
Zeller does it. His hands for the greatest passes. He knows how to roll and finish the
Chicago really passing to a success. By the great one. Here's Zeller. Doesn't go for him.
Well, listen, they own the boards. At both what one is for him and value. After rebounding, a clear focal point of their strategy.
Passes it to the great team, lays it up and points in the quarter.
He snuck, comes out on the other, sneaks underneath the bucket.
Zeller's
even, and he can't believe he doesn't knock it down.
Kid Gilchrist with the stand. Here we go. Horner again. Kid Gilchrist throws it down.
The breath, agility of Kid. It's remarkable how quickly
Moe's on the shot with two free throws for just how effective a defensive end. It's the one thing to do. A post-blending
portion of a great level in their quickness. See a guard attack. Notice if that big man comes up both feet like ours, doesn't have to block. But does he score? Does he get over there fast enough that the offensive grind to score and has to change? Continuous dribble. Right now, I'm by just being in the correct spot at the right time because you're not going to block the shot or deter the player from coming in. And so I would say watch how to do not necessarily high block shot where he is on his position.
Great tutorial. Clock at two. No good from Lamb.
Not a very consistent quarter in terms of a shoot.
How the great one. Charlotte.
Cheap turnover. You gotta make sure your targets were.
Kaminsky also making some changes. Looking in, he's checked in for Charlotte leading. Hit by Zeller for three. Gets the.
You have to love the. Damn, the hit jumpers off screens. Curl got to stick with the fit.
There's a screen. It's the pass to Payne. Hit. Now the fast break. Lamb with the. Here's. No good way. Now Warren. Oh, point outing it. Now he's three for five. 7 of 15 from the fourth, just under 50% shooting. It's Houston.
And don't forget, a playmaking was as good. He was in control out there.
Following the was Batum. Payne kicks. Payne. Works. By Holiday. By Charlotte. Kaminsky tonight.
They have been board dominant in this game and a factor in cracking this huge lead. Look, Zeller, very deliberate with.
Dishes. And oh, we blocked it in the fight. No good.
That's one he knows.
Chris, we all know you were a Pistons fan growing up, and of course, that means that plenty of chances to root. When you go back and you think, was there one Bulls player that you.
You know, a little C always cheered for Detroit, the Bulls. Isaiah and Jordan were my. But.
No. I really loved Artis Gilmore as well, but no, I had a player on I didn't really like.
The first free throw getting to the line, been by accident for Charlotte. Love it. Valentine coming. And he can't hit his NBA play to every arena, at least one. Does each arena have its players when they play on the floor? A depth perception from the, every building feels different. Is that true?
Yeah, every building does feel different. You know, it just depends on which guy, which form in there. I don't know playing that I used to love. I know some guys getting there or just love that city. What arena I really love, and it was the first, because I sat the parquet floor and I got to look up at all the, you know, kind of leader, who played their team, and so, and who's been there before you. And so every,
that's a great answer. Both of the game.
Right. Take a break. Two shots.
Game at the shooting guard spot. He's one of the best rebounders and a terrific passer and a very unselfish player.
Walker's checked in for Lamb. And the ball can get changed here as well. Here it's just checked in. With Batum, each part of that is big length as a...
Well, Batum is listed as 6. I mean, he's at the 7 player who gives you 6. Plus 8 rebound differential. Reason.
Nobody as the basket counts, and it's right here. One free throw coming up.
And he's got such touch and feel on the basket. He makes look easy.
Charlotte shooting their 7th free throw attempt.
Mind the line. One shot.
Here's Wells. And Miritich.
Look at that fast release of Miritich. Just remarkable as a big fella. So prepared to let it go.
On the wings, they're of their own. Stevenson's got to 14 now for Charlotte. And so we conclude the first half. Hornets lead by 14. We'll be back shortly live from Spectrum Center. Well, we're getting back to the action now. A one team so far. Seen Kemba won a game.
And sometimes you find a role you're not comfortable with, but his pass. The first half was impressive. Yeah, some of the defenses forced things and sticks.
Second half, here's Fred Hoiberg. Markkanen and Lopez are together down low. Dane out there with Wells. And at the small forward.
And Walker, you, every inch of his 6 foot for your shots really well.
Now here's Payne, guarded by Walker. Ben's Warren. Here's Lopez. Goes up again. Now on the play. One play.
Oh, they need to keep it up after missing these shots at the
half. The free throw line.
And it's percent line. Alas,
in the lane. One shot.
The free throws.
But in the game to the Bull Rose trade. He's always center. Play solid. Defense on the block. Plus when it's stretched out.
Now here's Walker. Stevenson can't hit.
Well, sometimes you can be, you may have surprised him.
Warren dishes the pick. To Warren. Out to the right wing. Trying to shoot. Payne, another bucket.
Can find a very good shot on that. Still able.
Walker kicks the bat. He feeds to the drop, and now a great flip.
On their heels. And the ball comes inside.
Payne, pass. Markkanen, can. Top of the key, Warren. Trying to break that.
Break.
Second shot up. Lopez, laying it. Lopez.
Oh, Lopez, I love seeing the board.
Bulls moving. Here's Wells. Reach and he's able to get it back. Hornets leading by 48. Puts it up from Smith by Stevens.
A perfectly effective release of that shot.
Here's Warren. 8 points for him. Hornets have gone through second half, developing against Warren. Screen by and the Kaminsky.
Most effective when he gets his feet set. Missy can be.
three. Reed's got seven rebounds.
Nothing going down for him today.
And some players, they'll end up in coaching just the way they watch the game and go about having played Hoiberg during
his close relationship being behind, but he hasn't much. He finds a may art. He's still.
Oh, here's Payne, guarded by Walker. Here is Markkanen. No scoring is likely to change. Stevenson nearly a foul. Get two shots coming up. Made one and missed one so far. Good for Lance Stevenson. Zeller used for Reed. Kick. And Jeremy Lamb subbed in for Walker. So, anchoring an era against the team considered the greatest of all time, that 96 Chicago had a great roster. Just thinking back to that second three-peat. What, when you were Bulls team?
Tough to play against that team. Jordan, the best player that's ever been, was so rebounding. Rodman, as well. He had guys in a system that, you know, just, it's hard to say. Of course, I haven't played against a team of all time. So once told me, you know, Ghosts can't caught up in comparing them. So, of course, they're the best of all time. But, it's fun watching these young kids play today.
By 12. From it's rebounded by the great one. Ago they've gone halftime, a little cold from the field. And there's the pass to Zeller. Stevenson right side. And there's the feed to Lane. Bulls trail by 12. There's the great one. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time. So two right here.
And free throw shooting has been in the game.
And is good.
One of the problems in the first half that they needed to fix that and much improved since the break.
Now,
you can't be missing shots like that in the spot on the pitch.
And Mirotic has it in the corner. Pushing by 10. Stevenson with a clean block. And it's by Stevenson.
A frustrating shot.
One. And with that one, the Mirotic. One's got 16 points.
An outstanding effort on offense this quarter. He will need to keep it.
From a lot of glass, that one's 16 points for him. And by 10. Green. Post.
Well, he's the same no matter what the score of the game is. Aggressive.
And called here for the
that button. A chance to kind of talk some things over.
And the chance to draw. This is a chess match.
Hornets making a chance. Walker's a chart here so far for Walker.
Mid-range game art form, but they are into it. The space is being accepted and have to make the D
better roll. Walker's showing them.
There's the double team with a three. Ball is good.
Love it when the big fella
leading by seven. Shot at the elbow. One is off. And this is the first time the Hornets this season.
Yeah, a four-game team.
Yeah, I have a wills, though. I mean, I'm trying to gain the upper hand, not just
a great one. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist making his last shot. The great one. Heard by Lane. Bounds. Charlotte takes possession. Making a change here. 13-second hit by Zeller. And Lamb kick. Hornets missing. So far in this one. Hornets a hit. And right after the bring you the start of the fun 2K Sports. And from a recent hunt in on head coach. And happy with the effort. Wants to see more.
And you know, you each other. And that's when this group is
in the books. And you welcome back as we move up and run laps courtesy of the quarter. But to Kid Gilchrist, the rangy wings. Kennedy. And it's Walker in the set the screen. The great one. Good. And it's his pick against the leather jacket.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working and getting good shots from close.
Kicks to Kid Gilchrist. Hit by now here's Kid to the rim. Here's the great one. He was fouled on the way up. Two free throws. Some changes. Lopez comes. Lacey in for Valentine. A few pisses over that play. By Fareed. Walker with it. And 8 points. For
well, that just is between himself. He likes to catch and shoot Jay defenders off their guard.
One passes to Lopez. It's blocked.
Hard to justify wide open.
Starting to wear on thin the perimeter focus. I like the finishes.
Shooting some changes. Great one. The pick. And Batum is over Payne.
Perfect position to grab that rebound and then get the
gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. And he dishes it to Lopez. Well. And also a missed shot.
Boxed covering. No cover.
A shot. Bulls trail by. Payne. Over Kaminsky. That misses. They've gone 3 of 7. 42% mark. And it's Kaminsky. Nobody. A three-pointer. No. Nope. Around 41% on the night. In the pass to Payne. Pass to Mark. Down the triple.
And is already mastered of the bank shot. Loves, you have got to be in his space if you want to disrupt his rhythm.
After the three-point, the Hornets lead by 12.
But the location of that's awesome. That was a sweet lead pass.
And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Shoot, that's good. Then.
Hey, man.
I'm Walker. To Fareed, and he could have one to go. And he'll go to the line. Gets on Lowry. And the game, he subsets the basketball shoe culture, the sneaker culture. Players competing almost as much Chris versus as they are points.
Oh, yeah, you know.
Stevenson's for Chicago. Great one comes in for well. Low Becker. 1-5. There's the Walker. The great one. Added by Kaminsky. Stevenson, Reed, it's the flight.
Marketing, using him on defense, and turns it up, and block.
Good, got the friendly to right side of the rim, second half. Passes to the great, Kaminsky with it up, and the Bulls with another miss.
And defender right in his face.
Well, he did a move, and getting right up on the jump shot.
And Walker kicks to Kaminsky, 10 feet away, again with the bucket.
As if he would never. After that all-star, but he's really
here's the great one. Stevenson dishes it to Walker. Fareed with a clean look is now in this one at the cold streak, and so he earns a trip to the line of Hecton Hillshoot. That free throw, no good. Good on the second free throw. Now Walker. Green. Off the pick. By the great one. 4 rebounds now. Last one. Stevenson with it. Outside. Right side.
And this is lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressibility to close. You really got to give it up for the Hornets.
Game where the defense, you know, steals, creating a lot of opportunities.
Gained possessions. And that effort, what will.
And it'll mark in on the year. Actually, their 5th win of the year.
And against the conference win of the season, psychological edge.
Greatness from this one.
Their offense had a great because of how well he was moving the ball. We're way up there, and he kept everybody moving, working to get open.
Stolen by Zeller. Stripped away. 8-second difference between the shot. Here's the great one, and he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly on that shot that time. The whistle blow. That's a foul. That free throw from the great one. 20s left to play in the final. Can just sit on the ball here.
They have earned.
And looks like the illegal kick. Right. Yep, that's right.
And he had to the bench here. He'll watch the rest of the.
Oh, that was it, y'all. Don't talk.
No problem, they get the win. A confident win and clearly showed the greater